So before Krishna there was Ganesh, and Ganesh was guiding me saying, you need to stop what you're doing now, you need to come back home, you have a duty to do. But Ganesh came to me first, and then Rama, and then Krishna. And Krishna was smiling at me saying, are you ready yet, Sophia? And I was completely still and speechless at seeing all this. As I said, I never believed in any of this. I was told to go to Egypt. They said, go to Egypt. The angel said, go to Egypt, go to Egypt. I booked a flight to Egypt 3 days later. I didn't know what I was doing in Egypt. I didn't have much knowledge about Egypt. All I know is that there's pyramids and Cleopatra and, you know, everybody does this, right? That's all I knew. I booked a tour guide, a spiritual tour guide, and the most incredible things happened in Egypt. The first thing when I went into a pyramid, as I got into the center of the pyramid, I started shaking and I started saying, Allahu Akbar Krishna Islam, Allahu Akbar Krishna Islam, Allahu Akbar Krishna Islam. I was confused. Who says Allahu Akbar and Krishna at the same time? Then I did some research. The Prophet Muhammad does talk about Krishna in the Hadith. Who knows that? Who knows that? Then I went to see the goddess Sekhmet. I wear her ring, she's the goddess of power and war. And I went into this little temple. And as soon as I walked in, I started breathing strange and speaking a language, which all I can call it is an ancient language, not of this time. The guardians of the temple, they look after the temple and they pass it down in their family. They started saying, the prophecy is coming real, the prophecy is coming real. 5 minutes this lasted, and I came out, and they just looked at me, and they were speaking in Arabic, and they said to the tour guide, we need to take her to a part of the temple. Tourists don't go there, so they took me to the temple. And as soon as I stepped up, I started to have memories of something terrible happening in that room. And I started crying and screaming, and again speaking this foreign language. And the guardians of the temple crying, because my reaction was so intense. I was screaming, I was crying, I was touching the floor, speaking this language. And the guardians of the temple put their hands in prayer and they bowed down to me. And they kept saying, the goddess is here, the prophecy is real, the prophecy is real. When I walked out of that room, I felt normal again. It wasn't like it was something strange, but something that was a part of who I am. I had a number of experiences like this in various temples. And the final part was when I went into a shop where they sell Egyptian oils. So they put, the guy put like frankincense oil, third eye oil, and incarnation oil. And all of a sudden my body got taken over and I could see the illusion of reality. And then Goddess Isis came and spoke and said, I am Isis, I'm here now. I came back to England and I understood that I was not who I am now, that this is, I needed to go back in my incarnations. And then a man phoned me. He's a shaman priest, and he said to me that he'd been having messages and visions from angels telling him who I am. So he said, we need to go into a deep meditation. And he came to my house, and we went into a deep meditation where the most sacred thing happened. And it was as if, it was like something opened up in the house. And I heard the voice of the mother, and she said that they'd been searching for me for thousands and thousands of years. And I need to take my responsibility. And I was like this, when I say me, I mean who I really am, was like this child who didn't know who she was, but was responding and knew the mother. And she told me that we are in the Garden of Eden. This earth is the Garden of Eden. You are living in the Garden of Eden right now. You have been lied to.
Can I ask something?
Sure. Did you want No,
it's fine. मैं जानना चाहूँगा कि आप ग्लैमर इंडस्ट्री में रही हैं, बॉलीवुड में काम किया, टीवी पे काम किया, हॉलीवुड फिल्म में काम किया, तो आपके लिए कितना मुश्किल है ये जो आपके लिए कितना मुश्किल है ये जो ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन है ग्लैमर वर्ल्ड से, और आप आपने शरण ली है स्पिरिचुअल वर्ल्ड में, आप ये ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन के बारे में बताइए, हाउ डिफिकल्ट इट इज?
It's not difficult at all. I have to apologize for the work that I did in the industry because I was presenting a fake reality. I wore makeup. Most people wear makeup. Makeup has cancer-causing chemicals in it. Why are we killing ourselves to look good? And what is looking good? Who decides what looking good is? Because now, I truly believe that looking good is not wearing makeup, because wearing makeup is killing you. Why are we killing ourselves and wearing a mask? This is beautiful. You know, whether you have spots or wrinkles or grey hair, this is beautiful. Makeup is killing you. Do people understand that? Face creams, makeup, it's killing you, it's cancerous. You look better. Someone told us that we look better with makeup.
अच्छा घर वालों का, family का, friends का, जो भी industry में लोग हैं, जब उनको पता चला आपके बारे में कि you're turning into this, उनका reaction क्या था? Were they shocked, surprised? क्या reaction था सबका जब आपने पहली बार उनको बताया कि I'm leaving everything?
I think some people said to me, do you want me to speak in English? कोई लोग बोल रहे थे कि एक्चुअली सोफिया आप स्पिरिचुअल भी बन सकती हो और एक्ट्रेस भी बन सकती हो, यू कैन स्टे एन एक्ट्रेस. और मैंने बोला आई एम नॉट एन एक्ट्रेस एनीमोर, आई वोक अप, आई बिकेम कॉन्शियस टू हू आई एम. इट्स नॉट फेयर, इट्स नॉट, द इंडस्ट्री इज नॉट फेयर बिकॉज दे आर टेलिंग वुमेन हाउ टू ड्रेस, हाउ टू बिहेव. सो अ वुमन इज नो लॉन्गर what a woman should be. A woman is a product of what someone is telling her to be, and men, normally it's a man. You know, it's generally a man who is telling you how to dress and what to be. So I listen to the directors or the magazine people, then the children look at me and they think that's how a woman should look.
So aap apne,
yeah. Okay. So I guess I have to apologize to all of my fans, especially the young children who are influenced by what they see on television, because I don't look like that. This is what I look like. Makeup is changing the way you look. And secondly, I'd say most celebrities have some form of surgery. Silicone implants, for example. Boobs are not meant to look like that.
You also had one.
Yeah. You want to know what this is? I'll show you. These were mine. Before I came to India, after my spiritual awakening, I took them out. This is what came out of my body. I'm sorry to all of those children that I made you think that you had to take and wear some of this. I apologize. I'm so sorry. Because no one should cut up their body and put these things in. We are teaching the children wrong things. I was teaching the children wrong things. We have a duty in the media to show the truth, but we are not. We're putting these in our body as poisonous. I was okay. I don't have a problem with my body. Look, they're perfect. They look great from the day they went in. But this is what I had inside my body. I'm still recovering from the operation. I had the operation 3 weeks ago to take them out. Because this is not what a woman should look like. Anybody in the media has a responsibility to children. Because children looked at me and said, I want to look like her, but this is what I was. And this is not what a woman is.